Hello, internet friends. My name is Bay. This is a forehead and a pretty normal shirt, and this is Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, but I'm bad. A light commentary playthrough here on the PlayStation 5 Entertainment Gaming System. And this is the Combat Simulator 3.2.2. We're level 35. We have a few things to do before we work on the main story. The last two episodes were kind of a lot of side questy stuff and mini games, but today, right now, shortly, main story. Let's do this. The Badlands Beasts. Yes. She asked, do I gotta?
Yes.
Oh.
And we're safe.
Now I gotta figure out, you know, put something on red. I think red is kind of pack muling right now. A bunch of materia. Pack cat wolfing. One round. If it's self-destruct, is it another giant bomb? It might be another giant bomb. It is the Mind Flayer again. What? Everything is always immune to gravity.
Your turn now.
Why don't you lead the
Let
way?
Let me handle this.
Bring it. Let's consult the case.
Why is he still on me? Moogle's supposed the big Moogle's supposed to have more aggro.
Get your hold.
To the limit and beyond.
Yeah. Ah! That was something.
Hey, shall we?
Forget him.
I hate how these mobs are like full tracking sometimes. What's the point? Trying to dodge. What the hell is that? So that's you have to stagger it. Okay. I never saw that the first time I fought him. Alright. I brought Moogle to think like it was gonna taunt him. I don't know why he's not taunting.
It's on you.
Leave it to me. Yeah. Thank you helping me out.
Of course, she moves just enough to be in there.
Let's consult
of you.
Can she just block that? Fair enough. I feel like Big Moogle actually worked then. The Mind Flayer stayed on him for a
bit.
That's
the way to do it.
Giving more time to bonk him. Other maybe skill self-destruct.
This data is incredible. Thank you for your contribution. Needless to say, many hazards await you.
What do I see? Deal a large amount of damage to enemies in the surrounding area while incapacitating self for 2 ATB. Could be good in Colosseum, maybe? Could be good in the Colosseum. Got a one round thing. Just doing a one round, or it's the last round, you just blow up to do a ton of damage. I feel like we've gotten a few other items, but again, it's hard to keep up with all the items you get because they don't. You can't page this list, so you can't look at it. It's all just order and. Best is the lowest, but all this stuff is all over the damn place. A lot of materia earrings is really cool. Who's got the AP up right now? Oh, because I wanted gravity to keep. Yep. So. Oh, Aerith doesn't have a steadfast block on. That's why she's getting messed up. I must have accidentally moved it. Well, the only thing she doesn't necessarily technically need here is the mana up. At this stage, we don't even have that much mana anyway. That's why. It makes sense. I did do a lot of moving around of materia recently, so. I guess ATB boost can get, but I think that might come in handy more later on in the game. Are all my steadfast blocks already taken? The answer was yes, but as much materia is in the game, it also feels like sometimes there's like not. Well, I just want him to be soaking something. I guess you can soak another MP up. I don't know. I might use two if they're maxed out, if I do Caster Cloud and Caster Aerith for different parties. I don't really think Caitsith needs offensive magic because he does so much stuff by himself anyway. Well, him and Moogle, but that's why Aerith was getting so messed up recently. She needs max steadfast block because she apparently gets targeted now a lot. Because the AI doesn't just target who you're controlling. Elemental materia, this is weird because a lot of it you get at like you get a lot of it at twos, so it's already like I have a lot of level three materia already, and I don't need to keep it on, but I don't want to take it off because of in case I need it. I guess there's not a lot of things other than stats that I could level right now. Whoops. How's our intel looking? Oh yeah, see these. Yeah, didn't scan any of those guys. The bloat floats? Oh, I need to scan a regular Tonberry at the Tonberry King. They're doing pretty alright. Oh, regular cactuars? Because there's gold, trots, orange. I didn't do the regular ones. They're just random. And I didn't do dine. Because I was on Barret at the time. Look at this lad. These are all bosses at the very bottom here. Okay.
The road. So take care.
Story time. Now, all the way down here, which I guess is through here. I probably should just summon the buggy. Okay. Guess it's just to my right.
Gunga's just past these shallows.
Gunga?
Yes, Aerith. Cloud's just learning how to three-point turn a lot right now. Oh. Oh, oh. Thank you. guess I'm assuming this whole area is for a side quest later or something? This giant swath of nothing? Suck it in, Cloud. Where are we going? I guess it is the rock section, yeah. Alright. A long way down though, so where are we? This whole area is not even connected. You just go on the buggy through the water. All this for nothing. This huge airfield. Gigantic debate. Being difficult now.
Hey, up ahead. That our jungle?
Indeed it is. Hold on, little Miss Carson. We're almost there.
Hooray.
Oh my god, I made it.
We'll need to carry on foot. Oh, I meant to say, there's a village up this way. Fancy popping in? The reactor's not going anywhere, and I bet we could all do with a wee cat nap, eh?
Sure, let's.
Cloud, you okay?
I feel like I've been here before.
Kujata? you know, crocodile bracelets. We can just freaking buy these. Surprised the game never gave you any. Did you get all the way to Gungaga? Now, if I buy, I'm gonna buy these and then watch. They're just gonna show up as drops eventually. Oh, there's some materia that I can use some AP on. This is a huge guild dump, is what I think is happening here. But are these not craftable? They're not. 21, 21. Twenty-one, forty-five, or 45, 21. Even though usually you always err on the side of magic defense, I think. Well, Aerith gets physical because she has built in additional magic defense. And they with red. So they would get physical. Everyone else would get magic. I don't know. I guess I could buy. Good lord. I'm gonna finish out some inventory stuff. Hold on. Live edit! Alright. Woo! That took a while. We're all sorted, new materia, moved around, whole bunch of stuff. Are we meant to go to this first tower? Some dirty bagpipes coming in. This is a one-way.
Okay, guys. Gloves up.
Rare Amphidex variant detected. Commencing guidance protocol. During mating season, the males undergo a chromatic change to attract females. Visual analysis suggests love is in the air. In order to draw its intended mate's attention, the Amphidex will let air resonate through its vocal sac, resulting in a romantic serenade. The melodic nature of its mating call is so intoxicating that other species have been known to fall under the Amphidex's spell and pursue an unrequited love. If you learn how to woo others like the Amphidex, you can defeat any enemy without a fight.
So cute, though. All right, Stagger, don't get frogged.
Wow! What a fight!
Best do it right.
Me to ice.
You got keep it together. Under control. Let's go.
Come on. They spam that. Oh, it looks like I should play Aerith. They can cast it at range.
Okay, guys. Gloves up.
Rare
I got your note. Keep it together.
So why don't you lead the
way? Let me see, guys. How come? During mating season, the males undergo a chromatic change to attract females. Visual analysis suggests love is in the air. In order to draw its intended mate's attention, the Amphidex will let air resonate through its vocal sac, resulting in a romantic serenade. The robotic nature of the mating call is so intoxicating that other species have been known to fall under the Amphidex's spell. If you learn how to woo others like the Amphidex, you could defeat any enemy without a fight.
Sonic Boom!
Easy. Too bad. On you.
I got this. There, you're gonna feel this one. Got
Time to celebrate.
Hello. The green. Makes sense. Like a little pink fern coconut butt. Do you want to get your cheeks pinched?
Yes.
So funky. Frogs.
Hey, King.
What is it?
If you're serious about wanting to be our new best friend, how about giving us some insider info?
Well, if it's dirty laundry you're after.
Yeah.
I have heard whispers about the new president's proclivities. Mm. You wouldn't believe how much he spends on those fancy suits.
Oh, why did I even ask?
Suits. Suits. I can't do the accent. It took a lot of practice. Mushrooms.
little workout.
Those poor Froogs. I can see why people were saying that Gaga is a bit of a pain because of the way it navigates. There's layers, there's a top layer, bottom layer, and it's very craggy. Oh.
Telling him where we are, you furry fraud!
Guilty!
I knew this cat had two faces!
Ah, come on now! I'm only pulling your leg!
Who are you kidding? You were literally built by the company! Probably stuffed you full of teeny-tiny listening devices!
Teeny-tiny? The late president believed that bigger was always better. Small went against his philosophy.
Knew him well, huh? Some 9-to-5 nobody you are. Sure your name ain't Stamp?
Pretty sure, aye.
Might want to check.
I love him. He must be protected at all costs. I need to go get the tower. Definitely a bit topsy-turvy here.
Won't take long.
Yeah.
Here it gets in. Going in.
One more shot. Gotcha.
I got your number.
Ah. Basically a Mandragora.
Go on. The limit and beyond. Not no. Bad, but not my best.
Oh, this is not the right way. I'm getting it. I'm understanding now. It's very loop-de-loopy. Very loop-de-loopy. It's the friggin' jungle. Oh. I realize I should have been reading these out. the whole time and not just letting people read them, because I bet it's probably better if I did this. In ancient times, Gongaga was settled by descendants of the Setra, who lived in quiet seclusion. The region was largely ignored by later kingdoms and empires until the Republic of Junon thought to expand its influence westward. They soon discovered, though, that the expansive established trade routes through such dense jungle far outweighed the benefits of reaching the small communities there, and elected to instead construct an airship and little else. Alright, sorry, it was expense, not expanse. The expense of establishing trade routes. Too expensive. When war erupted between the Republic of Shinra, people of the world over were impacted to varying degrees. Those in Gongaga were the rare exception, as being so far removed from the theater of war meant that they were no subject to forced conscription, nor were their villages ever host to the bloodshed. We'll go back and read the other ones later. Can't call Chocobo here. Can't call Buggy.
Someone lives all the way out here. In this wee hut. Talk about rustic. Then again, a life without Mako. It's not without its charm, is it? In fact, this could be a whole new string to the Shinra Resort's bow. Eh? The rural getaway. Cast off modernity and embrace its eternity. You'd be surprised how many people would go for it. Could be a nice little earner.
I'm assuming no one's here yet because they're not spawned. Oh, never mind. Nope.
Damn it. Not again. After all that time and effort. Is it the design? Not making any progress at all.
It's gonna... Oh.
No, no. You need to get to the heart of the problem. To hell with it. Back to square one. Huh? Who are you? Whatever, I don't have time to... That arm. That magnificent arm. It is a weapon. But how does it work? A universal adapter, allowing you to switch out weapons at will. But look at all these scratches. Wait, have you been going around punching things with your attachments?
Occasionally.
Doing so ought to have given you multiple bone fractures. But this unique cylinder provides unparalleled shock absorption, allowing for high impact performance. Who was the genius that built this?
An old friend, I guess. Don't know where he's at now, though.
Wait right there! Eureka! Sorry, got carried away. My name's Izo. I've been trying to create the ultimate weapon, but my attempts have all failed miserably. But thanks to you, I finally made a breakthrough. I must harness the inspiration while I can.
Mm-hmm.
Please, help me build it. Gather the materials I need. I'm originally from Junon, but I could hardly breathe there. So I decided to leave it all behind. I wandered in search of somewhere I could build my weapons in peace. And eventually, I wound up here. Not a bad place, huh? Of course, materials can be hard to come by when you live out here in the sticks. Though it seems crude at a glance, look close. The craftsmanship is remarkable. Whoever made it must have been a specialist in a completely different field. No mere weaponsmith would have been half as clever.
Ah.
Indeed. I've made it my life's work. Frustrating though it's been. How to conceive a weapon I lack the vocabulary to describe.
Well, if all you need is some material, sure. Why not? Just leave it to us.
Wonderful. Thank you. I believe I left a map in my storage shed that you can use to find what I need. Grab that before you head out, and you shouldn't have any trouble.
Alright.
Don't forget about that materials map I left in my storage shed. If you want to help me out, you'll need to know where to look.
Gotta say, never seen someone so interested in my arm. Most folks try their best to look the other way.
He's a weird one.
Huh. That's putting it mildly. Made me realize, too, how soft I've gotten. Because in the old days, I would have said no touching and decked his ass.
In the old days?
If it ain't the present, it's the past, son.
That's not the storage shed? A tiny shed, I guess? Draconite ore.
Must be the map Izo was talking about. Don't know what else it'd be. Well, let's see where it takes us. You ready?
So it's stamp.
Is this the place we're looking for?
Oh, great. Oh, great.
That was close.
Too bad. Deal with that.
All set. Go on. I'll run.
Copy. Couldn't have gone any better.
Everyone's dying.
For you. Go. Bring it. There.
Pour it on.
Bring it.
Keep it up.
I'm not going out like this.
Ouchies. In air combos, I noticed they're a little messed up. They are indeed a little messed up. Miserable.
Ready.
Super flying mob.
Give him your all.
Hey. Just a bit. Yeah.
Ugh.
Woo! I am on fire today. I've been pretty rough on you, I know. But you've always come through for me. Thanks, buddy. Don't know where I'd be without you.
Still got more to find.
I'm assuming it's up.
Is that everything? It is. Let's head back and check in with Isa.
It looks like there's multiple ways you could have approached it, so. I can just fast travel back to Izo's from here, so I was gonna try to double back down to get the tower. Bunnies. But got no chocobo yet. I already found a couple other things just by running around like a dingus.
Cloud, there are pockets within the Gungaga region that we still cannot scan, despite being within range of a tower. If anyone is capable of evading detection by Republic Tech, it must be...
Shinra.
Yes. Furthermore, as we have yet to detect a proto-relic, I suspect these issues may be related in some manner. I've marked the previously mentioned pockets on your map. And remember, when surveying, safety first.
Training facility. Okay. It's a lot more than I thought. Well, I did say main story, but this is still technically side quest.
You straight to where you can find my materials. Oh, but do keep an eye out for monsters. Excellent. It's all here. Thanks. If you're not in a rush, wait here while I finish up.
I get that it's your profession, but do you actually enjoy this, making weapons?
Of course I enjoy it. That's why I chose this job. Besides, it's the wielder who dictates the true value of a tool. Weapons, too. Aye, that's especially true for weapons. Yes, yes, I've done it! Feast your eyes on my masterpiece! My gift to you, I insist!
I may not be the gentlest owner, you know.
Use her as you like. The wielder dictates the value of the tool, remember? And by association, the value of the maker. Therefore, what good I put out into the world depends on who I entrust with my weapons. That's how I choose to see my part in it all.
Hell of a lot of pressure to put on some guy you just met, don't you think?
The adapter that your friend made. It's a gift in more ways than you know. He was thinking of your future, of what you might do after the dust settles. Today, you may have no choice but to wield a weapon. But tomorrow? Years from now? Think about it if you haven't. The man who fashioned your adapter is an inspiration in his own right, and that's no lie. Maybe one day you'll ask me to turn your arm into a giant egg beater. I'll make it so you can whip up a cake to serve 100.
Weird time to be joking around, man.
Not joking in the least. That's the price for my masterpiece. You owe me a cake fit for a king. So don't you go dying on me. You hear?
Yeah. Talk about a weirdo.
Friendly, though.
True. A weirdo with the heart of gold.
The Fafnir rifle doesn't have any connected materia slots, but it looks crazy. Oh, it has point blank. Definitely a caster favorite weapon. He has to finish off an enemy to get there's something else I just picked up. Oh, disempowerment. Binding. Well, I can only have so many materia. I just spent I don't know how long looking through all of it, so. Kind of makes you want to just get through to get your chocobo and get stuff rolling here, but man, it is a topsy-turvy little place. Well, I say little. The start of it right now, anyway. Quite a large zone.
Keep it together.
Let me handle it. Nope. Bring it. Keep it up.
Nothing to it.
Oh, yeah. Wait, where's the star shower from? Did I miss something? Oh, dive kick is no longer an in-air thing. Mug to be used in the air. Did I miss her getting it? Oh! When did she... Oh, these were a reward. Ah, these were a reward for the stuff I did a while ago. Whoopsie. Yikes, two materia slots. Let's steal an item economizer for now. What does she need to do? Follow up with an offensive ability or spell after using the weapon ability. Yes. Dive kick is weird now because you leap into the air and unleash a powerful kick. Before, it was just that. Maybe it's still synergistic for air. It doesn't say you can be used airborne, but you can combo it still. I think for now we'll put Star Shower here. Star Shower can't be used airborne, right? No. But you want a Star Shower into like an overpower, or Star Shower Focus Strike, or Star Shower Dive Kick, or I guess Star Shower Jump into the Air Reverse Gale, something like that. Those are very punchy gloves. They have lacking materia slots right now is tough. Hello? Oh.
It's on you.
I'll show you what
it's your turn.
Okay, let's go. One more shot. Bingo.
I think it has to be a double ATB. Yeah, probably does. If I have to Star Shower into the follow-up. No delay. Map look like it turned me around. Little cushion action. Whop. Little butt padding. Still a kind of a weird system. Bort? B-O-R-T. This way or that way?
Okay.
Deal with that.
All set. Gotcha. It's over. Bingo. Bring it. Shot. There. Moving on then.
Gosh, I missed Deadly Dodge. Is it not in the game? Deadly dodge and ATB assist, where are you at? Cloud, just... I don't even remember Kujata from original 7. Are they in 7? Is this a new summon? I guess I'll notice by the image. Oh, whoa. This big multi-headed dragon bison man. It's a big cow bull thing. I'm a little off, but does it actually have 3 heads?
Analysis complete. I managed to extract the necessary data from the crystal. This should allow me to strengthen your materia.
Thank you. I don't know why they made the decision to make it say that every single time, but whatever. My goodness, I'm not even gonna like really. I want to be heading as south as I can. Now, is swimming in jungle water advised? No. Absolutely not. The chance of you getting a butt tapeworm in jungle water, very high. Or worse. Like a tapeworm up the butt might be the least of your concerns. Can't talk to Porgin or anyone. He's just doing his own thing right now. We're heading west. of all the things to pop up on the map. Talon must be up there. That mushroom is moving. May not be able to get out of the water this way.
Come along. The village of Gongaga awaits.
It's about time. We're freaking starving.
Maybe our lucky food will be on the menu.
Tifa wants a steak. Get this woman a butter-basted salt and pepper garlic powder steak. A little rosemary and thyme, maybe?
Did you know, Cloud, that forest chocobos use mushrooms as springboards?
I don't have a forest chocobo yet, my dude. Huh. I just keep following the path. All right.
Mushrooms.
They may be hard to come by in Midgar, but here you can't even move for the blasted things.
Wow.
What?
Passing through.
Well, there she is.
You.
What?
Nothing. For a second, I thought you were someone else. Who are you people?
Aye, you'll do.
More importantly, why are you here? Not to survey the reactor, I presume.
Ach, no, just to study it. We're on a wee field trip, you see?
Well then.
Oh.
Welcome to Gongaga. I'm Cisne, Coalition Captain. And sorry, didn't mean to startle you before. Just doing our jobs. Back to your posts.
Ma'am.
You'll get a clear view of the reactor from that hill. Make sure to pay your respects, though.
Of course.
Come on.
We'll get your mushroom back, Kate Sith, don't worry. Or not.
Our village is a quiet one, as you can tell. Let's keep it that way. Don't get a lot of visitors, what with the jungle. Can't even remember the last time. But that's part of this place's charm, I suppose.
Hmm.
Thank you. So what is this?
3 years ago, the reactor here suffered a catastrophic failure. It was old and couldn't handle the stress.
It needed maintenance, which Shinra never provided. And then one day... So, they're cheap as well. This was the company's way of trying to make amends.
I'm surprised they even made the effort.
And thanks to the hard work of our people, Gongaga rose from the ashes, right?
That's nice and all, but one memorial doesn't buy absolution.
You guys must be tired. I know you've got things to do, but if you wanted to rest up...
Wouldn't they say no?
My house is just down there. Got an open door policy, so feel free.
Woohoo! Don't mind if I do!
I'm gonna take a look around. Seriously. Get some rest, okay?
You're damn right.
Those Gongaga mushrooms you found? They're all yours if you want them. We got more than our fair share. Didn't settle down here until after the reactor incident. Place may not seem like much compared to Midgar, but it's more than enough for me. Those Gongaga mushrooms you found? We got more than our fair share.
You know, I don't know how to walk in heels and or platforms, but like, I mean, the fact that Sisne is out here doing it in the jungle. Absolute Giga Chad move. But I think that'll do it for now. We've got a lot to do here, I imagine. Yep. Welcome to a new hub. We didn't even get anything on the way down here either, I don't think. Thank you for watching live if you have been. Thank you for watching on YouTube if you have been as well. Plenty more Final Fantasy VII Rebirth on the horizon. And of course, if you've missed any of the other playthroughs I have done, there's a lot of them. They're over on YouTube. You can search hashtag ButIMBad or just look at the playlists. I'll see you in the next one.